everyone. It's Ree Be Budgeting because yes, I be budgeting and cash stuffing. Welcome or welcome back to my channel where we are telling our money where to go so we're not left wondering where it went. Here we talk about all things cash envelope stuffing, budgeting, and some savings challenges. If that is something you're interested in or if you're just wanting to watch my journey and follow along, be sure to hit that subscribe button so you can catch all my uploads. And be sure to like this video and comment below so we can chit chat. Happy Wednesday, you guys. Today's video is going to be a budget with me for my second paycheck of June. I will leave my playlist in the cards above. You'll be able to see my first paycheck of June, budgeting and also cash stuffing. This is my smaller check of the month. One check really funds a lot of my bigger bills, which is this check. And so my leftover amount is much smaller, whereas my other check in my last video, that's my larger kind of fun check where I'm paying a lot of small bills, but I have a lot left over for my cash envelopes and sinking funds. So today will be budgeting what I will be getting paid on Friday, the 24th, I believe it is. Before I hop into the video for today, you guys, I did want to take a moment and just shout out the budgeting community link community that Budgeting April started. This is week 5 of the hashtag BCL challenge. And this will go through June 19th through June 25th. The channels are linked below. And what all you do is you subscribe to each of the channels below and you watch as many videos as you can. You just do what you can. We all have different work schedules, different personal lives. So we're not able to binge on everyone's channel. But even if you just watch a couple of their videos, like them, comment on them, definitely subscribe to their channel. It helps the budgeting community as a whole. I know I personally have been enjoying finding out about all these new channels, watching some of their videos, getting some ideas about savings challenges, different envelopes to have, and just how they do their budgeting. So again, they'll be listed below, but it's Kim the Budget Slayer, Row Budgets, who I've been following for a little while now. She gave me a bomb Netflix recommendation that I've been watching. Faith by Design and Simply Angie. And I'll also have April's channel below, the lady who started this. So just an amazing community. One thing that I've found to be true ever since starting my YouTube journey is that the budgeting channels and the community here is just super, super supportive and really helps you kind of stay motivated. And we hold each other accountable too. So super awesome. Okay, so let's get into this budget, you guys, and I apologize if I'm having to turn my notepad here, but it's just the way that I write. So this will be budgeting for our paycheck that's coming June 24th, and if you're new here, hello, welcome. I have gotten a few new subscribers since my last upload. So thank you so much for being here. But we are going to be budgeting off of $2,000. And I'm sure you're like, Ree, but your last budget with me was off of $2,000. And that is correct because remember, number one, this isn't my total deposit. Even though I'm a zero-based budgeter, that doesn't necessarily mean that I have $0 in my checking account. And so I always make sure that I budget off of a round dollar amount so that way I can leave a good amount of buffer in my checking account just in case there's any expenses, or sometimes you get those annual annoying recurring charges that you just forgot about. Something can come up. You can be at a store that their credit card or their they're not able to accept cash, or, you know, whoever knows. So you want to make sure that you have at least something in your checking account. As always, do what works best for you and your family and your situation, because I'm sure there are people, I'm sure out there who truly do zero-based budget. They go take out every last cent from their checking account. They may leave a dollar in there. They may have a set amount that they leave each deposit. But again, just whatever works for you, whatever makes sense for you and your brain, do that. So that's what we're going to be budgeting off of. Right now, I'm not doing any side hustles, any additional work. So I only have my salary job and I get paid bi-weekly, so twice a month. So on the fixed expenses, and again, I apologize for my slanted notepad, we're just trying to write here. So this is the check that pays my mortgage. Again, if you've been watching my videos, then you know I bought my house in August of 2020. And so this is why I say this is my smaller check, because as you can see, my mortgage takes up a big chunk of what I get paid. And so that's due on the first, paid on the first. Then this check, I also take care of another one of my debts. I know I keep teasing about doing my debt confession. It is coming. It's in the works. but yes, I take care of one of my debts this check as well. And then I have a couple subscriptions that are coming out within the next couple of weeks. So this check also, I use it to pay any bills that are due the first 2 weeks of the month. So basically, this check will be taking care of any bills coming out July 1st through July 14th. And so the subscriptions that are coming out this check have a few different paydays, so I'm not going to put the day there, but it is good when you're using some kind of budgeting system to make sure, or format, that you're writing the day that it's due. But these are all due basically around within the couple of days of the first, and so that is $72. And then you'll see I'm also filling out this actual column, because these don't change from month to month. They're literally the exact same. So that's really it for this check. And as you can see, I'll show you, because I still have it. So with my paycheck on the 10th, I had a lot more bills, but they were kind of smaller amounts, you know, a couple $100 amounts, couple $200. But whereas this check, one fixed expense alone is $1,400. So that's why you see a little bit of change there with how I budget each check. So now what we're going to do is just add up my fixed expenses. And that is going to give us 1,599, so $1,599. Sorry, move it this way. You can kind of see my calculator, because this might work a little bit better, I'm thinking. Okay, so now we're going to take 2,000, so that's the total amount that we got paid, or we will get paid, and subtract 1,599. And so that leaves us with $401. And this is why it's so good, you guys, to take a moment to sit down and write out your budget. I know a lot of people, even me, live like, well, I know what's in my checking account. I know when my bills are due. You know, I know how much I got, so I'm gonna just keep swiping my debit card. But when you write stuff down, you guys, it really does make you think about the number of bills, the type of bills, where your money is going. Because when I tell y'all, except for maybe gas, I would blow through this $400. And sometimes in a weekend, in a day, and have nothing to show for it. And I say except maybe gas, because I obviously was out and about running the streets, being outside, as they say. And so I would make sure there was gas in my car. Probably would at least make sure my nails were done. But other than that, like, this money would just fly away. And I would have no idea why I don't have any money. It's like one bill that I forgot, or one maintenance issue on the car, or something happens, one wrong thing happens, and I had nowhere to pull from. And so this is why I think, just as I keep saying in my videos, budgeting this way, cash stuffing envelopes, creating sinking funds is just really helping me develop a better relationship with money, because now I'm telling this $400 exactly where to go. So now let's head over to our cash envelopes, because that's a priority area for me, because as you'll see, this is where I put gas in my car. Y'all, I am going up. I finally am biting the bullet and I'm taking my gas budget up $20 more. I do work from home. However, my weekends are just super active and it's the summertime. So every weekend I'm just out and about every day. And so that's where a lot of my gas is going, just on the weekends. So I am moving it up from $60 to $80. I will be putting money in my self-care cash envelope, for my nail appointment. That will be Friday. And then I'm going to put some money in my family short term. We're going to the Denver Zoo for my niece's birthday. So I typically don't put this much in my family short term envelope, but I'm going to need it for, tickets and, just everything that we'll be doing that day slash weekend. So I'm stuffing this right now for then. My spend cash envelope will still be getting its usual 25. My just us envelope will be getting 25. My giving will be getting $7. And then miscellaneous will be getting $5. In this area, these cash envelopes are what I carry with me on a day-to-day basis. This prevents me from swiping my card, again, as I mentioned earlier, and just running up a tab. My cash envelopes help me stay disciplined, because once this envelope is empty, I'm done on self-care. Once this envelope is empty, I'm done spending money. And so it's really helping me be more mindful about my spending. So let's add these up and see where we are. Okay, so we are at 282. And then if you remember, we brought over 401. So we're going to take 282 from 401. And that's going to leave us with $119 to put into our sinking funds. And again, even if, you know, back then when I was living wild and free, even if I did do some of these things, still that 119, who knows where it would go. You know, probably eating out and grabbing drinks with friends or shopping online or whatever. But the good thing about budgeting, and I know I'll always preach this, is that it doesn't have to be so restrictive to where you're taking away things that you love to do. I love spending time with my family, so I'm going to make sure I budget for them. I love getting my nails done, so I'm going to budget for my nails. I love being able to give to folks that I see may be in need, so I'm going to budget that. Me and my my boyfriend will go on dates and hang out and do stuff, so I'm going to make sure I'm budgeting for those things instead of dipping into bill money or using a credit card that I know I'm not going to pay back by the due date, things like that. So this 119, you guys, we're going to put towards our sinking funds. And I'll probably do them in a little bit of, no, I will do them in a little bit of a different order this time, just because I have some priorities for this check since we do have this money. So, if you watched my last cash stuffing, I did start the 100 envelope challenge and I pulled, just move this over for a second, and I pulled 44. So because I'm staying committed to this challenge, I know it's going to be a slow burn. I know it's going to take a while, but I am staying committed to this challenge. And so I'm going to prioritize putting $44 in there first. Then I'm also starting to track my Christmas savings. And so Christmas, this check is getting $25. Again, in my last video, I stuffed $35, I think it was, if I'm not mistaken, or $30. Yeah, I stuffed $30, but I was supposed to stuff $55 for the month of June. And so I did $30 last check, and I'm doing $25 this check. So that'll equal, when I say $55, yes. So then I'm also checking my, or tracking, excuse me, my emergency fund. And this check is getting $10. And I did actually end up going in my emergency fund for a house emergency this past month. So I put myself an IOU, except for I just can't do it on this check. I'll do it on my next check. So you'll see emergency kind of fluctuate the next two stuffings. But it's because I'm putting some money back where it needs to be. My family long-term sinking fund is going to be getting 10. The birthdays, this is again envelopes that I will try to stuff every single check. Come hell or high water, I'll do my best to try to put something in these envelopes. If you saw my last video, you probably saw that I hit just about, I think I did, not even just about, but I put something in every single envelope. Whereas this check, because it's my smaller check, I do have to make some decisions and maybe not stuff some envelopes this time, but at least focus on some that are the highest priority, which this is going to help me anyway. Sorry, I just bumped the stand here, because right now I don't have a low priority, high priority, medium high priority binder system. It's just kind of all together. But I think the more I budget this way, I'll start to develop, okay, well, you always stuff these envelopes, so that those must be high priority. And it's like, well, those envelopes you kind of skip here and there, so then they may take on the more medium or low priority. So I'm hoping this will help me do that. So let's add up what's going in our sinking funds. Hopefully it should be 119. Awesome. So yes, this totaled 119. And again, remember, we brought down a balance of 119. We budgeted out these envelopes to get money for sinking funds. That equals 119. And that's how we get to the zero-based budget. So my total income, as we said, is going to be $2,000. And then when we add up this $1,599, this $282 and this $119, we should also get $2,000. Boom. And we do. And so that's what is meant by zero-based budgeting. We really gave each dollar a job. We gave it something to do. I know I have birthdays coming up all summer. Why not put some money aside? I know my nieces and nephews are going to need things when we're out and about as a family. Put some money aside. I know my car, I want to keep my car running as smooth as possible since I just paid it off last month. I want to work on keeping it going and running smooth for at least the next, you know, two, 3 years. Start putting money aside for things that you know are happening. Because as we know, life be life and y'all. So that is today's Budget With Me video, you guys. Obviously, this is another thing that I'll harp on. Do what works for you. Do what makes sense for you and your family. There's no one correct way to budget. I think as long as you're putting effort into it and you're writing out your bills and you're making sure that you're just not swiping your card mindlessly, spending your money without really thinking about where it's going, why it's going there, and definitely starting to save. Sometimes it could feel very daunting to even think about saving when we're just trying to put gas in the car and groceries in the refrigerator. But once you write out your budget this way, it opens your eyes to the possibility that, yeah, you actually can put $20 aside for your child's birthday, or you can put $10 aside for Christmas, even though Christmas is, you know, 5 months away. You can start even just putting $5, $10 to the side right now can help you be better prepared for Christmas as opposed to waiting until December. So anyways, y'all, I'm getting on my soapbox and preaching. But thank you so much if you made it this far in the video. Thanks so much for watching. On Friday, you will actually see me stuff these envelopes. So come, make sure you come back for that. And in the meantime, as I always say, be kind to yourselves, be kind to each other, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye, y'all.